On April 1, 2019, the Indian Space Research Organization, ISRO, deployed an intelligence satellite, EMISAT, along with 28 customer satellites. This April launch comes 2 years after ISRO launched a record-breaking 104 satellites on a single rocket, an event that both the international news media and the space community looked at very carefully. Since its conception in 1969, ISRO has completed a total of 185 missions and is fast becoming one of the most effective and competitive space agencies in the world. It has also become an important cog in the wheel of India's future prosperity and technological and scientific progress. Indian space program began in an era when the country was rife with internal problems of poverty, hunger, and illiteracy. So how did ISRO manage to make it one of the most successful space programs on the planet? Before we get into that, what is a successful space program? To build a working space program, you need these three basic things. Number one, satellites. They orbit the Earth and provide information gathering and communication capabilities. Number two, launch vehicles. You need something to break through the Earth's gravitational pull. Launch vehicles are rockets that do just that by using different kinds of fuels. Number three, ground infrastructure. Infrastructure is needed to launch and communicate with the satellites. This includes launch sites and communication centers. Now that we know what makes a successful space program, let's have a look at the history of ISRO. ISRO was formed in 1969 with two broad aims. First, application of space assets in helping the development of the country, and secondly, achieving self-reliance in manufacturing and launching capabilities. In fact, the very first experiments ISRO did were in areas of remote sensing, where they successfully detected diseases in crops and telecommunications, using satellites to broadcast educational programs to rural parts of the country. Broadly speaking, Indian space odyssey can be divided into four phases. The first phase started in 1962 with the creation of Indian National Committee for Space Research, INCOSPAR. During this phase, the reasons for developing a space program and its future course were spelled out. It was Vikram Sarabhai's vision to start India's space program as a means to uplift the then socio-economic poor country that led to its early success. In 1963, with the help of the United States, the Soviet Union, and France, Tumba Equatorial Rocket Launching Station was set up in Kerala. And in the same year, a US-made rocket, Nike Apache, was launched to 200 kilometers. This marked India's entry into space, which led to the country launching its very first sounding rockets, Rohini, in 1969. And in the same year, INCOSPAR was superseded by ISRO. In the 70s and the 80s, space program started its second phase, which was consolidation of the plans that were set up in the first phase, and a lot of experiments. During this time, the various applications of potential satellites were thoroughly tested. By the mid-80s, India began manufacturing its own satellites, set up the launch vehicle program, and started working on the required space infrastructure. In 1975, India's first satellite, Aryabhatta, was launched by the Soviets on a Cosmos 3M rocket. The satellite was dedicated to measuring stellar X-rays, and although it failed after just 41 orbits, it gave ISRO first-hand experience, which helped them improve their technology. After that, the duo of Bhaskar 1 and Bhaskar 2 became India's first successful satellites. In 1981, ISRO, in cooperation with the European Space Agency, launched Ariane Passenger Payload Experiment Satellite, APO, the country's first telecommunication satellite. India's first launch vehicle, Satellite Launch Vehicle or SLV-3, was also successfully tested during this time, and India became the sixth country with its own launch vehicles. The SLV program was led by none other than a brilliant young APJ Abdul Kalam. In the 90s, after all the aspects were tested and calibrated, ISRO began its operational phase. Multiple satellites were manufactured and launched for purposes of observation, telecommunication, broadcasting, and meteorology. The two major launch vehicles, Polar Satellite Launch Vehicle PSLV and Geosynchronous Satellite Launch Vehicle GSLV, were also developed during this time. This marked India's almost complete independence from relying on other nations for satellite launch and manufacturing capabilities. The fourth and the current stage began with the 21st century, as India started looking towards space exploration and a more militaristic use of its space assets. This includes a substantial increase in the number of active satellites and India's missions to orbits of Moon and Mars. India in 2008 sent the Chandrayaan 1 successfully to the lunar orbit, where it helped in confirming the presence of frozen water deposits. In 2013, ISRO made history by sending a frugal but successful mission to Mars, Mangalyaan 1, which made India the first country to successfully reach Mars orbit on the first attempt, and fourth country in the world to reach the red planet. The current phase also includes the heightened cooperation between Indian Defence Forces and ISRO, which led to the deployment of multiple reconnaissance satellites. In the last week of March 2019, India also successfully tested an anti-satellite missile, cementing its place in global space arms race. In a new ISRO innovation, the PSLV, after deploying the satellites, shifts its orbit in the fourth stage to perform scientific experiments. ISRO's commercial arm Antariksh, that provides satellite launch services to other countries, has deployed almost 300 foreign satellites till date, and now competes directly with Ariane Space, SpaceX and Roscosmos for micro and light satellite launches. Let's have a look again at the three things that a successful space program needs and see how India is doing. Satellites. India currently has multiple satellites under Indian Remote Sensing for observation, Indian National Satellite System, INSAT, for telecommunication and meteorology, and Indian Regional Navigation Satellite System for positioning, navigation and timing. Altogether, ISRO has an estimated 45 active satellites in orbit. Launch vehicles. Over the years, ISRO has developed two major launch vehicles, the Polar Satellite Launch Vehicle, PSLV, for lighter satellites with 44 successful launches, and the Geosynchronous Satellite Launch Vehicle, GSLV, for heavier communication satellites with 8 successful launches. In the 90s, ISRO developed and used Augmented Satellite Launch Vehicle, ASLV, as a stepping stone to the eventual development of the PSLV and the GSLV. For even heavier satellites like the GSATs, ISRO currently contracts France's Ariane Space that uses Ariane 5 launch vehicle. Ground infrastructure. The Satish Dhawan Space Center Shar in Sriharikota, Andhra Pradesh is ISRO's launch site, with two launch pads for the PSLVs and the GSLVs and a launch service for sounding rockets. It also has facilities for vehicle assembly, testing and a mission control center. In March 2019, Shar opened a viewing gallery where spectators can watch launches as they happen. And you must remember, all this achieved over the years on a significant lower budget than other spacefaring nations. India is thinking of a significant increase in its number of active satellites, with around 70 satellites planned for the next 5 years. ISRO is also working on three new launch vehicles. A unified launch vehicle ULV that will be able to carry up to 10,000 kilograms of payload to the low Earth orbit and will likely replace both the PSLV and the GSLV. They're also in the final testing phase of small satellite launch vehicle SSLV, which will carry smaller payloads of 500 kilograms. But apart from these, ISRO is also testing reusable launch vehicle, which can launch, complete its mission in orbit and land back safely on Earth's surface. It is expected to take around 10 years to develop. The country is also returning to the moon sometime in 2019 with Chandrayaan 2, but this time they're going to land on and explore the lunar surface with Pragyan rover near the south pole of the moon. Other planned projects include the second Mars orbiter mission, or Mangalyaan 2, by 2023, a mission to observe the sun Aditya L1 in 2021, and a planned mission to Venus Shukrayaan 1 in 2023. But the most interesting of them all is India's human spaceflight mission, Gaganyaan, which will send three Indians to 400 kilometers above Earth's surface for 7 days by 2022. All the technologies for this mission have been developed and are currently undergoing rigorous testing. If it succeeds, India will become only the fourth country after Russia, USA and China to carry out crewed missions. Further developments to the project include rendezvous and docking systems. India's reason for starting the space program was not of national security, but of taking its population out of poverty by addressing its multifaceted socio-economic issues. The country's space journey has been unique since the space program was created as a useful tool for a developing nation to help and empower its citizens. And as India moves towards being a developed nation, ISRO's role in its future becomes increasingly vital. Thanks for watching. Please like and share the video and subscribe for more.